Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Reproduction in Plants. In that, we are studying topic self-pollination. When I say self-pollination, self means an individual flower. And when I say pollination, it means transfer of gametes, that is male and female, in the same flower. Today, we'll be studying how it is done. Self-pollination. If I break that word self-pollination, self means a single flower which is present on one plant. And when I say pollination, it means transfer of gametes. So during the process of self-pollination, what happens is the transfer of pollen grains, that is the stigma, or you can say the transfer of pollen grain, the male gametophyte to the female gametophyte, takes place in the same flower. In simple language, you can say the transfer of pollen grains from the anther, where pollen grains are present, takes place to the stigma, where the female gametophyte is present, in the same flower. So there will be only one flower involved in it. In one viscous, this process of self-pollination takes place. Now, self-pollination can be of autogamy type or geitonogamy type. Well, this pollination takes place in one flower, that is in one hibiscus, and hibiscus is present on a single flower, or you can say on a single plant, it is called as autogamy. Whereas if the pollination is taking place between two flowers which are of same species, for example, two different hibiscus, both are same species hibiscus, and this both hibiscus are present at different position on the same plant, it is called as geitonogamy. So remember, in self-pollination, the flowers have to be present on the same plant, whether it is autogamy or whether it is geitonogamy. Now, there are various plants which do self-pollination, or you can say autogamy. Sunflower is there, or hibiscus is there, mirabilis is there, solanum is there. There are a lot of them. Now, for doing self-pollination, there are few agencies which are required, and devices that favor self-pollination are homogamy and clusterogamy. When I say homogamy, the word homo means similar and gamy means gametes. So we can understand something having similar gametes. Maybe the flowers have similar gametes, or one flower has both male and female gametes inside itself. Yes, homogamy means both the male and female gametes are present inside the same flower. Self-pollination, and the definition of self-pollination goes, it is a transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of the same flower. Self-pollination is also called as autogamy, but when transfer of pollen grains takes place between neighboring flowers present on the same plants, it is called as geitonogamy. Now, to help self-pollination process or to carry out self-pollination smoothly, there are two agencies or factors that help the process of self-pollination, which are homogamy and cleistogamy. When I say homogamy, it means bisexual flowers, and bisexual flowers have both the male and the female gamete in the same flower, while the other one is cleistogamy. And in cleistogamy, what happens is the flowers never expose their sex organs, and the pollen grains directly fall on the stigma and it reaches to the egg where near the ovary, and the process of fertilization can take place. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about self-pollination, which takes place on a single plant. In self-pollination, there is only one single plant, and there are only flowers which could be of same species present on that plant. I hope you all are clear with the concept of self-pollination. Thank you.